Unconditional. Last verse. The ultimate love song. I play it on piano. It's better on piano. If you get an idea, right?
Es el último. Es el, el okay. La canción de amor. La mejor canción de amor.
And you can hate me. And you can kill me. Or embrace me. You can do anything that you want. But you're always my Lord, unconditionally. My one and only Lord, conditionally. My one and only Lord, unconditionally. Hare Krishna. Hare This song is dedicated to Nadia. Sometimes Krishna does things she doesn't like, so she has to sing this song.
Esta canción está dedicada a Nadia porque a veces Krishna quiere que hagamos cosas que no queremos.
You can. This is your song, Nadia. You can.
Esta love es tu canción, Nadia.
You can hate me. You want to translate?
Puedes amarme, puedes odiarme.
You can kill me or embrace me.
Puedes matarme o puedes abrazarme.
You are free to do anything that you want.
Puedes hacer lo que quieras.
But you're always my Lord. You're always my Lord unconditionally. No, that doesn't make sense, does it? I'm always your servant unconditionally. You can do anything and everything you want. That's it.
Puedes hacer lo que quieras.
Yeah, when you wake up in the morning, Nadi, you can sing this part. You can do anything and everything you want.
Nadia, cuando te levantes en la mañana, puedes cantar esta parte. Puedes hacer todo lo que quieras, Señor.
You can do anything and everything you want.
Puedes hacer todo y todo lo que quieras.
You can do anything and everything you want.
Puedes hacer cualquier cosa y todo lo que quieras.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Everyone, one of us.
Todos.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Jesu Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. One more time. How do you say it in Spanish? You can do anything and everything you want.
Puedes hacer cualquier cosa y todo lo que quieras.
Okay, you want to sing it? You can do anything and everything you want. 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 Shashastakam verso 8. Srimati Radharani. Prayer, how do you say prayer?
Prayers oración.
Prayers of Srimati Radharani.
Rezos, oraciones de Srimati Radharani.
Yes. All of you like my new house?
¿Les gusta mi nueva casa? It's so nice.
This is my Zen meditation room.
Es mi cuarto de meditación Zen.
Yeah, and I can get a new house. I'm getting new houses all the time.
Y estoy adquiriendo nuevas casas todo el tiempo.
I'll just roll this house up and I'll put down another one.
Solo enrollo esta casa y pongo otra.
Anyway, this is, how does the camera look, Prem?
¿Cómo se ve la cámara, Prem?
It's okay?
Yeah, it looks good, clear. The lighting matches the background you got too. Pretty cool.
With the DSL you get, it might be a little more blurry in the back, but I think they make these a little out of focus, so.
Creo que estas las desenfocan. Estos fondos los desenfocan.
Okay. So we have to bring up the document, right?
Tenemos que sacar el documento, ¿verdad? Oh, we have two questions from 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
One is from Gopal Krishna Das. Hare Krishna, mientras estemos mejorando nuestra forma de reaccionar, ¿es posible estar cerca de Krishna? Hare Krishna, while we are improving ourselves, improving the way we react, is it possible to be closer to Krishna?
Closer. Close or closer?
Oh, sorry. Close to Krishna?
Uh-huh. Yes.
Sí.
As close as you want.
Tan cerca como tú quieras.
Nobody's stopping you.
Nadie te está deteniendo.
You know, Krishna doesn't judge you like your mother does.
Krishna no te juzga como tu mamá.
No, your grandmother or your school teacher or... Krishna accepts you as you are if you're sincere.
O tu abuela o tu maestra, Krishna te acepta como eres.
So, you know, don't think of Krishna like you would, like an ordinary person.
Así que no pienses en Krishna como si él fuera una persona ordinaria.
Until you finish, you get rid of all your anarthas, I don't want to see your ugly face. That's not what Krishna says.
Hasta que te deshagas de tus anarthas, no quiero ver tu cara fea. No es lo que dice Krishna.
And so some of us think that Krishna doesn't like us because other people in this world may not like us when we make mistakes.
Algunas veces pensamos que Krishna puede que a él no le agrademos porque pensamos que no le agradamos a otras personas por los errores que cometemos.
Now here's a beautiful thought.
Aquí hay un hermoso pensamiento.
Krishna is only one thought away.
Krishna solo está un pensamiento de distancia de nosotros.
Krishna is only one mantra away.
Krishna solo está un mantra de distancia.
He's only one verse away.
Solo está un verso de distancia.
I was joking with the Chinese devotee Saturday night. I said, even though you're full of anartha, sweet rice still tastes good, doesn't it?
Estaba bromeando con un devoto, con unos devotos chinos el sábado en la noche y le está diciendo, a pesar de que estás lleno de anartas, el arroz dulce sigue sabiendo bien, ¿no es así? Sí.
So, no matter what your condition is, you can relish devotional service and you can think of Krishna and then he's close when you're thinking of him.
Sin importar cuál sea tu condición, tú puedes tener un gusto por el servicio de devocional y puedes estar cerca de Krishna.
Right? Sweet rice tastes good to you?
¿El arroz dulce sabe bien para ustedes?
Chant your rounds, don't chant your rounds. Still tastes good. It tastes better if you chant your rounds, but still tastes good.
Cantes o no cantes bien tus rondas, sigue sabiendo bien, ¿no? Y claro, si cantas buenas rondas, sabe mejor.
Have you ever heard a beautiful kirtan and you just feel so, you feel emotional? The kirtan's so beautiful.
¿Alguna vez han escuchado un kirtan y se sienten muy, muy, muy emocionales porque el kirtan es tan hermoso?
Everybody's feeling it.
Hare
Krishna. Everybody's feeling it.
Todos lo están sintiendo.
Todos. The ones with todos anarthas or nada anarthas. Everybody's feeling it.
Todos, inclusive todos los que tienen anarthas y todos los que no tienen anarthas. Todos lo están sintiendo.
Of course, if you have no anarthas, you'll feel it more.
Por supuesto, si no tienes anarthas, lo vas a sentir más.
But still, everybody's feeling it.
Todos lo están sintiendo.
So the only thing blocking the relationship is us.
Los únicos que estamos bloqueando la relación somos nosotros.
Here's Krishna, here's you.
Aquí está Krishna y aquí estás tú.
Krishna stays in the same place. We kind of go all over the place, right?
Krishna se queda en el mismo lugar y nosotros nos vamos por todos los lugares.
Can I get closer to Krishna? Yeah, just go this way.
¿Quieres acercarte a Krishna? Sí, ve en esta dirección.
So we're going like this and we're asking, can I get closer to Krishna?
Vamos así y nos vamos así y pensamos, oh, quiero estar cerca de Krishna.
We're doing everything wrong and saying, can I get closer to Krishna? Well, not if you go this way.
Y hacemos todo lo equivocado y pensamos, ¿puedo estar cerca de Krishna?
Does that make sense?
No, si haces eso. ¿Esto tiene sentido?
Cierto, tiene sentido.
Cierto.
Cierto. Cierto, tiene sentido. I only know the Mexican accent. I don't know the other accents because, I grew up in California. Grew up in California, I know the Mexican accent. I talk like that, man,
Solo conozco el acento mexicano porque crecí en California.
No es problema. Hare Krishna, no es problema. Puro devoto, no problema. Babu. Me gusta Krishna mucho, me gusta mucho Krishna, conciencia de Krishna. También pasada, me gusta mucho. Todas las cosas, todas las cosas con Krishna me gustó mucho. Especialmente Pakora. Ah, está bien, muy bien. Okay. Next question.
Okay, la siguiente pregunta. From Bhagagrahi Das.
From who?
Bhagagrahi Das.
Bhagagrahi Chinardana.
¿Cuál es el proceso sistemático del perdón? ¿Qué pasos se deben seguir? What is the systematic process for forgiving? What steps should you take?
I can tell you one step tonight.
Te puedo dar un paso esta noche.
But you should take our course because there's about 20 or 25 steps.
Debes de tomar nuestro curso porque hay como 20 o 25 pasos.
And different steps affect people differently.
Y diferentes pasos afectan a las personas de diferentes maneras.
So, I personally think the problem is we need, you see, forgiveness is such a, it, to just go from zero to forgiveness, it's a really huge step.
Yo personalmente creo que ir de cero al perdón es un muy gran paso.
Because when we're resentful, we're feeling like this person is bad, they did the wrong thing, it was unjust, so like they don't deserve to be forgiven.
Porque cuando estamos resentidos pensamos esta persona hizo lo incorrecto, no hizo lo que debería haber hecho y es un gran paso a tomar, no podemos pensar en el perdón.
So I'll give you an example.
Les voy a dar un ejemplo.
I don't know if I gave you this example last week, but I just thought of this example recently.
No sé si se los dije la vez pasada, pero acabo de pensar en ello.
Let's say you have different containers.
Digamos que tienen diferentes contenedores.
With different fragrances.
Con diferentes fragancias.
Like this container has rose fragrance.
Este contenedor, por ejemplo, tiene fragancia de rosas.
And the containers are wood, so it stays in the wood.
Contenedores son de madera, entonces esa fragancia se queda en la madera.
And this container has orange fragrance.
Y este otro tiene fragancia de naranja.
And this one has limón.
Y este otro tiene limón.
And this one has cucumber.
Y este otro tiene pepino.
Pepino. And so the different ones.
Así que hay diferentes.
And one of them has alcohol fragrance.
Y uno tiene una fragancia de alcohol.
And one of them has skunk fragrance.
Y otro tiene orines de zorrillo.
And one of them has dog stool fragrance. Well, it's not a fragrance. Odor.
Y el otro
odor.
Tiene odor a popo de perro.
So you have different containers with different fragrances and different odors.
Así que tienes contenedores con diferentes fragancias y diferentes odores.
So the containers are compared to our consciousness.
Los contenedores son comparados con nuestra conciencia.
So the world's always throwing water at you.
Así que el mundo siempre te está aventando agua.
And the water hits our container and the water takes on the fragrance or the odor of our consciousness.
Y el agua toca estos contenedores y se llena de la fragancia o el olor de estos contenedores.
So you could say resentment is on the odor side and forgiveness is on the fragrance side.
Así que podemos decir que el resentimiento está en la parte de los olores y el perdón está en la parte de las fragancias.
So, when something happens to you,
cuando
the water comes in, and sometimes the water gets fragrant and sometimes it stinks, depending on which container you decide to put it in.
Y a veces el agua pesta y a veces el agua tiene una fragancia, dependiendo de en qué contenedor la pones.
So you can name the different fragrances, like kindness or empathy or compassion, understanding. And then you can name the odors, resentment, hatred, anger, envy, being right, and so forth. So it depends what container it goes in. That's how you're going to react. That's what the water is going to taste like.
Y entonces podemos nombrar a las fragancias, por ejemplo, empatía, compasión, entendimiento, bondad, y a los olores, resentimiento, envidia, enojo, querer tener la razón. Y entonces depende dónde tú vas a poner esa agua.
So here's the interesting thing about the analogy.
Aquí está lo interesante de esta analogía.
Even if someone mistreats you, the water still comes in neutral. It has no fragrance. It doesn't get its fragrance or odor till it comes into you, even if it's a bad thing.
Incluso cuando si algo malo te pasa, el agua queda neutra, no tiene ningún odor ni fragancia hasta que llega a ti.
We think it's coming in with an odor. It's not. We're putting the odor on it.
Pensamos que ya viene con un odor, pero no, nosotros somos los que le ponemos ese odor.
I mean, how many times have I said, Haridas Thakur, Vasudev Dutta, Prahlad Maharaj, Jesus Christ, you know, it was all, the worst thing was coming at them, and it was all becoming scented, fragrant water, jasmine water, and rose water, and orange water.
¿Cuántas veces he dicho que lo que le llegaba a, por ejemplo, a Vasudev Datta o Prahlad Maharaj era agua con fragancia de rosas ni de olor a fragancia naranja ni nada de eso?
So if we remember that when something bad happens and say, my experience is going to be based on what container I put this experience in. Not the experience itself, but what container I put it in. And then I can ask myself, what container do I want to put this experience in?
Entonces todo tiene que ver con el recipiente en la que queremos poner esa experiencia y luego por preguntarnos en qué recipiente puse esta experiencia.
Prem Kishore, could you write that down and send it to me? Because I think I should do a daily video, but if it's
analogy.
I don't
the
have
analogy,
anything to
yeah.
write here. Yeah. Just write and say daily video, the example of the containers. Otherwise, I may forget.
I
feel so fortunate, Krishna. He gives me so many examples.
Me siento muy afortunada que Krishna me da muchos ejemplos.
I think I like to help people, so Krishna says, "Okay, I'll give you some examples."
Krishna sabe que quiere ayudar a las personas, entonces dice, "Okay, te voy a dar unos ejemplos."
But I get so many, I can't remember them all.
Pero tengo tantos que a veces no puedo recordarlos todos.
So this is very helpful as a beginning point of understanding about forgiveness, that it's not the event that's causing you to be resentful. It's the container you're putting it in.
Esto es un buen inicio para empezar a entender el perdón, de que no es el evento, sino en qué recipiente yo lo estoy poniendo ese evento.
So one of the things, I think one of the most important things for a devotee,
una de las cosas más importantes para el devoto,
is not to condemn people without understanding the people.
No es condenar a las personas sin haber entendido a la persona.
Like, Like sometimes we condemn people because they do foolish things, but no one ever told them the right thing to do. So they're just doing the wrong thing because that's all they know.
A veces condenamos a las personas porque hicieron algo indebido, pero nadie le enseñó a esa persona lo que era correcto.
Right? Lots of nice people in Mexico, and most of them are meat eaters because they think that's what you're supposed to do.
Hay muchas buenas personas en México, pero la mayoría comen carne, pero es porque nadie les enseñó qué hacer, que era algo mejor de hacer.
So we know it's wrong, but
sabemos
we know
que
most,
es incorrecto.
But we know most people are innocent.
Pero sabemos que la mayoría de las personas son inocentes.
I think I told you the story where one devotee was once kind of condemning non-devotees for their foolishness or their sinful activity.
Creo que les conté esta historia donde un devoto estaba condenando a los no devotos por sus actividades pecaminosas.
And Prabhupada said, well, a short while ago, you were just like all these people.
Y Prabhupada le dijo, bueno, hace no mucho, tú eras como estas personas.
So it was Prabhupada trying to get him to be compassionate, not condemning.
Prabhupada estaba tratando de que él fuera compasivo, no condenándolo.
So, I think when I meditate on resentment and I meditate on compassion,
cuando yo medito en el resentimiento y en la compasión,
it seems to me compassion is the exact opposite of resentment.
Me parece que la compasión es exactamente lo opuesto al resentimiento.
Because compassion asks us to understand why the person did this. What's going on for them? What's their challenge?
Porque la compasión nos lleva a preguntarnos por qué hizo esto, por qué lo llevó a hacer esto.
And compassion asks us not to condemn, but to help, to pray for, to understand.
Y la compasión nos lleva a no condenar, sino a ayudar.
So if you're going to forgive, if you want a step, I think all the steps, every step I could teach is included in compassion.
Así que de todos los pasos que te puedo enseñar, todos están incluidos en la compasión.
You see, a lot of times we expect things from people and they don't give it to us.
Muchas veces esperamos cosas de las personas y no nos las dan.
A lot of times they can't give it to us, but we get upset. Why aren't they giving it to me? They should give it to me, but maybe they can't.
Y muchas veces puede que no nos las puedan dar y nosotros nos molestamos de que no nos las pueden dar, pero es porque no pueden.
Maybe they don't know how. Maybe they don't know how.
A lo mejor no saben cómo.
Maybe they don't know you want that from them.
A lo mejor no saben que tú quieres eso de ellos.
Maybe they couldn't do it even if they wanted to.
A lo mejor no podrían hacerlo incluso si ellos quisieran.
So, compassion creates that kind of empathy or that kind of sympathy. So you start thinking that way. And so instead of condemning them, you understand them.
Entonces la compasión nos lleva a tener ese tipo de empatía y en vez de condenarlos, los entendemos.
Correcto.
Correcto.
Correcto. So Prabhupada said, in a purport, I think maybe sixth canto, Prabhupada said, compassion is the foremost quality. It's the most, how did he say it? It's the most outstanding quality of a devotee.
Prabhupada dijo en el canto número 6 que la compasión es la mayor cualidad en un devoto.
And within compassion, there's so many subcategories of so many other good qualities.
Y con la compasión hay otras subcategorías también de cualidades.
And compassion means you're really putting yourself in another person's shoes.
Y la compasión significa que te estás poniendo a ti mismo en los zapatos de alguien más.
What do they say? You can't understand another person. And the Indian, American Indian, say you can't understand another person until you walk a mile in his moccasins. Something like that.
Como hay un proverbio indio indio americano que dice que no puedes entender a otra persona a menos que hayas caminado una milla en los mocasines de la otra persona.
Mocasinos, mocasinos.
Mocasines.
These Spanish words sound so funny to me. Moccasins become moccasinos. Sounds like a bunch of little kids got together and made up a language.
Estas palabras en español se escuchan súper chistosas,
We
que
won't
provienen
call
de
them
hacer
moccasins, we'll call
otro.
them mocasinos. That sounds like fun.
No hay que llamarles mocasins, hay que llamarles mocasinos.
Actually, it's a beautiful language.
De hecho, es una hermosa lengua.
And Italian and French is all
Y el
nice.
italiano y el francés.
This person is bad.
Esta persona es mala.
Well, let me try to understand why he's bad.
Bueno, déjame tratar de entender por qué es así, por qué es mala.
When I was preparing a course on, I was giving a course to men on the dangers of pornography. I watched a video of a man who, or the danger, sexual control, a man who had, I think, murdered, raped and murdered 34 women. Interview with him, and he was on death row. Just, yeah.
Cuando estaba haciendo este curso, cuando estaba haciendo un curso para hombres que estaban enfrentando los peligros de la pornografía o sobre el control sexual, había entrevistado una persona que había, perdón, vio un video de una persona que la habían entrevistado que había violado y asesinado a 34 mujeres.
So I forget the details, but basically said when I was a kid, I was just a normal boy. I was a Christian. I went to church, had a normal family. And something happened, and something happened, and something happened, and he became addicted to sex like a drug addict who needed more and more drugs, and it eventually ended up that it wasn't exciting unless he killed the woman, believe it or not. But when you hear the story, we can't condone what he did, but when you hear the story, at least you understand a little more why a person would do such a crazy thing.
Cuando él estaba diciendo que de ni él era un niño normal, que hacía cosas normales de niño, que era un niño cristiano y que después pasaron cosas y pasaron otras cosas y demás cosas que hicieron que él se volviera adicto al sexo y como un drogadicto no podía controlar esa adicción. Y llegó al punto en que no se volvía interesante sino llegaba ya a matar a la mujer. Entonces,
So,
eso no condona la acción, pero por lo menos nos acerca a entender por qué hizo eso.
you would think of this, a person that would do that, you would think this man is the scum of the earth.
Y puedes pensar, bueno, este tipo de hombres es la escoria de todo el mundo.
But there's a story behind it. There's a person behind it who suffered a lot.
Pero hay una historia atrás de esa persona. Hay una persona que sufrió mucho.
So, like I said, we're not condoning his activity,
Como dije, no
but
estamos condonando la acción.
understanding a person's life and challenges
Pero
helps
entender
you forgive.
los problemas y los retos de las personas, eso ayuda.
In the forgiveness literature, one of the things that's often said, that in most cases, the majority of cases, the person who hurt you does not intend to hurt you. They
En la
didn't wake up thinking, I'm going to hurt you.
literatura del perdón se dice que la mayoría de las veces la persona no tenía ningún tipo de intención de lastimarte.
Many devotees have explained to me that they had very difficult childhoods because their parents were just very hard on them. Demeaning or critical, neglectful.
Muchos devotos me han dicho que han tenido una niñez muy difícil por sus padres porque los minimizaban, los criticaban, los juzgaban.
And a lot of those devotees need to forgive their parents for that.
Y muchos de esos devotos necesitaban perdonar a sus padres por ello.
And part of the forgiveness is that in most cases, or many cases, the parents were just doing what their parents did to them. And they weren't even aware, like, that they were really doing anything wrong. It's just that's how they were treated.
Y parte de esos casos era porque los padres así habían sido creados y solo estaban reproduciendo lo que sus papás les hicieron a ellos y no estaban conscientes de que eso estaba mal.
Or in some cases, the parents were so troubled, stressed, or emotionally troubled, they couldn't handle being parents. And that's why the kids were mistreated, but it wasn't intentional.
O en algunos otros casos, por ejemplo, los padres tenían demasiado estrés y estaban perturbados emocionalmente
Oh, yeah.
por ser padres y los maltrataban, pero no era intencional.
I have a beautiful story.
Tengo una hermosa historia.
I think I've told it before, but it's been so long you probably all forgot.
Creo que ya se las conté, pero ya pasó tanto tiempo que seguro ya lo olvidaron.
But a lot of you haven't heard this story.
Pero seguro que
And
muchos de ustedes no la han escuchado.
this story was told to me by a devotee who was attending a workshop in which people had to make amends with someone that had hurt them.
Y esta historia me la contó un devoto que fue a un taller donde tenía que enmendar las cosas con una persona.
So what they do in the workshop is they ask you to talk to that person, call them or go visit them and try to make amends.
Y lo que te hacen hacer en el taller es que le hables a esa persona o la vayas a ver para arreglar las cosas, para enmendar las cosas.
So this one boy was adopted, was put up for adoption at birth. So he had a real issue with his mother, and so he confronted her.
Y este niño fue puesto en adopción desde que era muy pequeño y él tenía problemas con su madre y entonces un día lo enfrentó.
And he had never talked about it. He was a young man. He'd never talked about it with her, and he was really upset.
Y él era un hombre joven, nunca había hablado de eso. Él estaba muy molesto y habló, decidió hablar con ella.
So, you think his whole life he's just kind of, he's so, his whole life he's just completely, I don't know what's the word, just, yeah, completely angry with his birth mother. He just can't understand why a mother would give away the child. It just drove him crazy.
Piensen que toda su vida él estaba muy molesto, no podía realmente comprender por qué su madre de nacimiento lo había abandonado, ¿no? ¿Quién podría hacer algo así?
So he told her that. He said, how could you have done that? Like, what could be worse than a mother giving away a child? You did like the worst thing any mother could possibly do. And I just like I can't understand it, and I can't get over it.
Y él le dijo esto a ella, le dijo, no, no puedo superar cómo es que pudiste haber hecho esto, eso es lo peor que puede hacer alguien, ¿no? Una madre que abandona a su hijo.
So we're talking about how, by understanding what a person has gone through, then that can neutralize your resentment. So I'm going to
Estamos
tell you what she said, because it neutralized his resentment, what he heard from her.
Hablando de las cosas que neutraliza nuestro resentimiento al entender a la otra persona. Y les voy a compartir lo que la mujer dijo.
She told her story, and when he heard her story of why she gave him up, he completely turned 180 degrees when he heard that story.
Y ella le contó una historia de por qué hizo lo que hizo, y después de escucharla, él completamente cambió 360 grados.
And the story was so was so intense that he just broke down when he heard the story. And he felt so bad that he had doubted his mother all these years.
Y la historia fue tan intensa que lo rompió por completo a él.
All these years. But he felt really bad that he had all this resentment towards his mother for all these years because he didn't know the story.
Y se había sentido mal de que había tenido tanto resentimiento todos estos años porque no conocía la historia de su madre.
And you're all sitting there saying, "Tell me the story. What's the story? What's the story?"
Y todos están sentados pensando, ¿cuál es la historia? Quiero saber la historia.
It's an amazing story.
Es una increíble historia.
Yeah. You want to hear it?
¿Quieren escucharla? Sí.
She was a drug addict.
Ella era una drogadicta.
When he was born, she was a drug addict.
Cuando nació, ella era una drogadicta.
So she told him, "The worst thing I could have done for you is to keep you, because I wouldn't be able to take care of you."
Ella le dijo, lo peor que hubiera podido hacer era criarte porque lo hubiera hecho muy mal.
He said, "So I put you up for adoption because that was the best thing for you."
Te puse en adopción porque eso sabía que eso era lo que iba a ser mejor para ti.
But I haven't told you the thing that he broke down here.
Pero no les he dicho lo que lo rompió, lo que lo dejó en pedazos al escuchar.
It's really heavy.
Es muy fuerte.
And you can understand that by understanding another person's story, it can completely remove all your enmity towards them. And I'll tell you what she said.
Y esto es lo que hace que al escuchar la historia de otra persona, completamente deshaga tu enemistad hacia ella.
She said, "Giving you away was the most difficult thing I ever did in my life." And when he heard that, it was like everything switched.
El dejarte es la cosa más difícil que he hecho en toda mi vida. Y al escuchar esto, él cambió por completo.
Because he thought she was heartless to give him away. And when he heard that, all that resentment, all the 25 years of anger, resentment, was finished.
Porque él pensó que ella era una desalmada, pero al escuchar que había sido tan difícil para ella, entonces todo el resentimiento, todo el odio de 25 años se deshizo.
And you know what I think is really important about this discussion is that we often deal with devotees who act in ways which are we'll just say not so nice.
Y lo que es bueno de esta discusión es que a veces pensamos que a veces los devotos que actúan en formas que no son buenas.
I have a question for you. Have you ever seen a devotee act in a way that wasn't so nice? Ever that ever happened to you?
Tengo una pregunta por
Am I the only one that happened to?
¿Alguna vez ha habido devotos que han actuado en una forma que no ha sido tan buena? ¿O solo me ha pasado a mí?
Kishore Mani is like, "Yeah, 365 days a year I see that."
Kishore dice, sí, 365 días al año.
So if you take this attitude of like, there's got to be a story behind all of this.
Si tomas esto de que debe de haber una historia detrás de lo que pasó.
And you may never actually come to get the story. It may be complicated.
Pero puede que nunca puedas llegar a esa historia.
But there's a story, believe me.
Pero hay una historia, créame.
And probably, if you were in their shoes, you'd probably do the same thing they did. Does that make sense?
¿Eso tiene sentido?
Yeah, so I think, you know, always before we condemn and make judgments and make decisions, we should always try to understand people as best we can understand them. Hmm.
Vamos.
Rasika, I can't hear you. Can everyone else hear Rasika? Because she's cutting out. You can hear her? Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. my block thing got pressed by accident.
I'm next to her, so I can hear.
Okay. All right. Yeah. So you can. My point is, you can apply this in ordinary dealings if a devotee is not being so nice, to try to understand what may have contributed that. You know, there's something throughout their life that's made them act that way.
Entonces pueden aplicar a esto a los devotos que no han sido tan buenos con esto, con ustedes, y entender que algo en su vida los llevó a hacer así.
So we still may have to take some action in dealing with them, but we will deal in a different way when we understand their challenges.
Puede que tengan que tomar ciertas acciones contra ellos, pero también podemos entender sus acciones.
Now, if we look at Prabhupada, we can say that the driving force behind Prabhupada is compassion.
Si vemos, por ejemplo, a Prabhupada, vemos que su motivador era la compasión.
I read this amazing quote, and Prabhupada said, "You're all younger men than I am, but I have more energy than you."
Leí esta cita maravillosa que dijo que todos ustedes son hombres jóvenes, pero yo tengo mucha más energía que ustedes.
But then he said something to explain that. That's really interesting.
Pero luego dijo algo para explicarlo, lo cual es muy interesante.
He said, "My body has very little energy, but I'm inspired to serve Krishna."
Dijo, mi cuerpo tiene muy poca energía, pero yo estoy muy inspirado de servir a Krishna.
Wow. Isn't that interesting?
¿No es eso interesante? Yes.
Why did I say that? What was the point before that? I forgot. What was the...
Understanding someone's story and that we should have compassion for them.
Entender la historia de otras personas y tener compasión por ellas.
How did I get to the Prabhupada story from that? I
can't. Y de cómo llegué a la historia de Prabhupada.
I can't figure out the bridge to the story. What was...
Because you were saying that...
Porque
we may not even understand this story, but we should have compassion. There must be a story behind.
Porque debe de haber una historia, aunque no la conozcas. Hay una historia.
Like so many things about Prabhupada we don't even understand.
Muchas cosas, incluso sobre Prabhupada, que no entendemos.
That's one of them.
Esa es una de ellas.
His bad his body was because he was always energetic.
No sabemos qué en qué tan malas condiciones estaba su cuerpo porque él siempre tenía energía.
No. I remember because I was saying Prabhupada's the example of compassion.
No. Ahora recuerdo porque estaba diciendo el ejemplo de compasión de Prabhupada.
No body has no energy, but he's going. So the compassion is pushing him.
Porque su cuerpo no tenía energía, pero la compasión lo impulsaba.
If you think about it, when we talk about service, really compassion is the essence of service. It's the essence of the consciousness of service.
Cuando pensamos en el servicio, de hecho, la compasión es la base de la conciencia de servir.
And I would say,
y yo diría,
that selfishness is in one sense the antithesis of compassion.
Que el
selfishness,
el egoísmo es lo contrario a la compasión. Thank you.
Yeah. So that if we are developing compassion, then it's purifying that selfish tendency, which is the cause of our material existence.
Si desarrollamos la compasión, entonces nos deshacemos del egoísmo, que es de hecho la causa de nuestra existencia material.
When you're serving another person, you forget that You're the enjoyer. It's when you stop serving, you start thinking, I'm the enjoyer, where's the pizza? Right?
Cuando te olvidas de que eres el disfrutador, entonces, cuando sirves, te olvidas de que eres el disfrutador.
Frijoles,
pero cuando terminas de servir, entonces preguntas, ¿dónde está la pizza? ¿Dónde está mi pizza? ¿Dónde están mis frijoles?
That's the wrong country, yeah. Where's the frijoles?
Es el país equivocado, más bien frijoles. ¿Dónde están mis frijoles?
But it's we were talking. I don't know if it was with you or another, or maybe it was last week. And I was saying how in my experience, when you're in one consciousness, there's not room for the antithesis to that consciousness. So like when you're in a compassionate mode, there's not like room for selfishness. When you're in selfish mode, there's not, let's go out. Oh, I don't want to go out. It's too cold. You know, there's like the one mood dominates and it doesn't leave room for the other mood. And then I asked Gabrielle, because she's a psychologist, is that true? No, it was with the Chinese devotees. I said, is that true? We had two psychologists, and they said, yeah. You get occupied in one consciousness, which knocks out the antithesis of that consciousness.
Estaba hablando la semana pasada en una clase con unos devotos chinos. Había dos psicólogas y estábamos diciendo, yo estaba hablando sobre cuando tenemos una conciencia, no hay lugar para lo contrario. Por ejemplo, si tenemos una conciencia de compasión, no está lo contrario, que es el egoísmo, y uno domina al otro. Yo les pregunté si eso era verdad y me dijeron que sí.
Just like Lakshmi Priya was organizing the boat festival.
So she was like, Priya estaba organizando el festival de los botes.
She didn't eat or sleep for a whole week.
Ella no durmió ni comió por toda una semana.
Well, maybe she ate and slept a little bit, yeah.
Oh, sí, un poquito.
But we all have that experience. We get absorbed in some service that's like, oh my God. A lot of times I actually forget meals. It's like 2 in the afternoon. I go, oh my God, I didn't eat breakfast today. Happens all the time.
A todos nos ha pasado que nos absorbemos en un servicio y dejamos de, por ejemplo, de comer, ¿no? Yo muchas veces me absorbo tanto que dejo una, que me salto una comida, son las 2 de la tarde y digo, ay, no desayuné.
You forget to take care of yourself because you're taking care of somebody else. So that's how it works.
Y te olvidas de cuidarte a ti mismo porque estás cuidando de alguien más. Así es como funciona.
And so, you know, it's good to understand these things because we want to know what are the actions and consciousness that are contrary to all the wrong things we do and all the wrong things we think.
Es bueno entender estas cosas porque queremos saber cuál es la conciencia contraria, lo contrario a todas las cosas erróneas que hacemos.
So, you know, so some people may think, well, forgiveness is not that important, but when you understand, you have to develop compassion to be forgiving and the benefits of compassion, then it makes sense. Oh, this is really like the essence of Krishna consciousness is compassion, which is really the basis of forgiveness.
Y a veces las personas dicen que desarrollar el perdón no es tan importante, pero ya que se dan cuenta de que el perdón tiene que ver con la compasión, es la esencia del perdón y con la compasión hay muchos otros beneficios, ¿no? Y en realidad, pues es la esencia de la conciencia de Krishna.
Good? Good or good?
Good.
Bueno or bueno? Verda or verda? Yeah. It's a good point to remember.
Es un buen punto que debemos de recordar, ¿no es así?
Like, you know, like often when I talk to men and I say, you know, you should think, when you think of women, you should think how you can serve them. That's your only relation. Your only relation is to serve them, protect them, and respect them. Only those three things, nothing else. Serve, protect, respect. Kind of like policemen, right? Serve, protect. Yeah, so you're the male police to serve, protect, and respect women.
Es como cuando yo hablo con los hombres y les digo, la única relación que puedes tener con las mujeres es para servirlas, protegerlas o respetarlas. Ustedes son como los policías de las mujeres, nada más.
Because that is the opposite of objectifying women or seeing women as objects. These three things are the exact opposite. And that's why you always have to switch to the opposite to purify yourself.
Y estas tres cosas son completamente lo opuesto a ver a una mujer como un objeto. Entonces, así es. No tenemos que pensar en lo opuesto para purificarnos.
So you can think that way about anything. You know, if you're doing the wrong thing or thinking the wrong thing, think, well, what's the opposite? Because once you get the opposite, there's no room for the wrong thought, and vice versa. When you get all the wrong thoughts and actions, there's no room for the right ones.
Y esto lo podemos aplicar a todo, ¿no? Cuando tenemos unos malos pensamientos, entonces pensamos completamente el opuesto y entonces ya no hay cabida, ya no hay lugar para lo demás.
That's why appreciation is so good, because when you appreciate, there's no room for criticism. It
Por
doesn't
eso la
fit
apreciación es
in
tan
there.
buena.
There's no compartment in your head for criticism when you're appreciating.
La apreciación es tan buena porque cuando hay apreciación, entonces no hay lugar para la crítica. Ese lugar de la crítica en el cerebro ya no está.
No compartment for appreciation when you're criticizing.
Y no hay lugar para la apreciación cuando estás criticando.
Test it out if you don't believe me. See what happens.
Pruébenlo si no me creen y vean qué pasa.
Test out the appreciation, not the criticism.
Pongan a prueba la parte de la apreciación, no la parte de la crítica.
So don't underestimate the power of compassion.
No subestimen el poder de la compasión.
So Lakshmi Priya says, but devotees are humble and they don't like to be appreciated. No, they just say that. They like it, believe me.
Pero los devotos son humildes y no les gusta recibir apreciación. No, sí les gusta, créeme. Solo dicen eso.
When they say, please don't glorify me, they're really saying, I love glorification so much, it's not good for me, so better you don't do it. That's what they're saying.
Cuando dicen, no, por favor, no lo hagas, lo que en realidad están diciendo es que sí, me gusta tanto que no sé que no es bueno para mí, entonces por eso mejor no lo hagas.
You didn't know that, Lakshmi Priya?
¿Sabías esto, Lakshmi Priya?
Oh, Mother Divya. Well, she's transcendental, but we're just talking about ordinary people.
Divya, pero ella es trascendental. Estamos hablando de personas ordinarias.
Lot of devotees do not like to be glorified because they know it just incites the ego.
Muchos devotos no quieren ser glorificados porque saben que eso simplemente le da rienda suelta al ego.
It creates a nice atmosphere.
Pero crea una buena atmósfera.
If it's sincere,
Si es sincero.
then it creates a beautiful atmosphere.
Crea un ambiente hermoso.
Oh, Lakshmi Priya, that boat festival was so good. You did such a good job.
La
And
Shripriya
creates a
Festival de
nice
los Botes fue
atmosphere.
maravilloso. Hiciste algo maravilloso. Eso crea un ambiente hermoso.
And it's good for the people who are appreciating you.
Y es bueno también para las personas que te están apreciando.
And if it's a question between you being criticized or you being appreciated, you'd probably choose appreciation, wouldn't
Y
you?
si es cuestión de, ya sea que escoja ser criticada o apreciada, pues mejor ser apreciada.
Because if you want to be See, Lakshmi Priya is very humble. She's giving all
Lakshmi Priya
credit to
es muy
everybody else.
humilde.
Yeah. I'm just using you as one of the examples.
Sí, yo solo te estoy usando como un
But
ejemplo.
But I think all of us, if we, most of us, if we had a choice to be criticized or appreciated, we'd probably choose appreciation.
Pero claro, para la mayoría de, de nosotros, si eligiéramos entre ser criticados o apreciados, escogeríamos ser apreciados.
And at least if we were leaders of a temple, we would choose, said, let's have appreciation. We don't want criticism. It doesn't help.
Y si fuéramos, pero si fuéramos líderes de un templo y solo escogiéramos la, la apreciación y no la crítica, eso no sería bueno.
Yeah.
There are some other things.
Abu, why don't you glorify devotees? Oh, they're supposed to be humble. They're going to get puffed up if I glorify them. No. Lord Chaitanya said to glorify devotees is the perfection of speech.
Oh, Prabhu, ¿por qué no glorificas a los devotos? Oh, porque si no, si los glorifico, entonces se van a enorgullecer y eso no va a ser bueno. No, el señor Chaitanya dijo que glorificar es la perfección del habla.
Oh, Lakshmi Priya, that boat festival was great, but I'm not going to glorify you because you get puffed up. Yeah,
Lakshmi Priya, ese festival de bote fue maravilloso, pero no te voy a glorificar porque te enorgulleces. No.
This one spiritual master, his disciples said, I'm doing book distribution, yeah, but you know, I don't feel like I'm doing anything. I'm not inspired. I don't feel appreciated.
Le dijeron a este maestro espiritual, oye, yo hago distribución de libros, pero siento que no estoy siendo apreciado.
And the spiritual master said, you're doing such amazing service. If you want to be glorified, come see me every day and I'll glorify you every day for distributing Prabhupada's books.
Tú estás haciendo un servicio tan maravilloso y te preocupas por no ser apreciado, ven a verme todos los días y yo te voy a apreciar por distribuir los libros de Prabhupada.
If it's done genuinely and sincerely and it's taken humbly, then it's powerful.
Si se hace de forma sincera y se toma humildemente, eso es muy poderoso.
And also what a devotee thinks is when the devotee is being glorified, the devotee thinks, well, this is how this devotee sees me, so now I have to act like that.
Y lo que piensa el devoto es, bueno, esta es la forma en la que este otro devoto me está viendo. Ahora yo debo de actuar así, como me ve.
Oh, Lakshmi Priya, you're such a good devotee. Uh-oh, I better be a good devotee.
Oh, Lakshmi Priya, eres tan buena devota. Ahora tengo que actuar como una buena devota.
That's how a devotee thinks.
Así es como piensa el devoto.
The devotee thinks, this devotee is so advanced, he sees everyone as a good devotee.
O este devoto es tan avanzado que ve a todos como buenos devotos.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Henry Santa María is saying, ¿es bueno hacer críticas? Is it good to criticize?
Yourself.
Sí, es bueno criticarte a ti mismo.
If you have a tendency to criticize,
si tienes una tendencia a criticar,
use it to find out what's wrong with yourself and improve yourself.
Úsalo para ver qué hay de malo en ti y mejorarte a ti mismo.
Otherwise, criticism is destructive.
De otra forma, la crítica es destructiva.
It's actually a symptom of a problem. If someone is always, you know, sometimes when you see a problem, you say, well, he always criticizes, that's the problem. It's the symptom of a deeper problem. It's not the real problem, it's just the symptom.
Cuando criticas, de hecho, en realidad es el síntoma de otro problema.
So, you know, if you're always criticizing, so, oh, they deserve it, they're doing everything wrong. No, it's the symptom of your own problem. That's how you have to see it.
Lo merecen, siempre están haciendo lo incorrecto. No, en realidad es un síntoma de un problema que tú tienes.
And what's the problem? The problem is I have to criticize. That's the problem. Not what he's doing. The problem is I have to criticize. That's how we have to see it.
¿Cuál es el problema? El problema no es lo que está haciendo, sino el problema es que yo tengo que criticar. Tengo esa tendencia a criticar.
Yeah. Criticism, yeah. We're destroying ourselves. And
sí, en
another
la crítica
person.
Nos destruimos a nosotros mismos, no a otra persona.
And the thing about criticism is anybody can do it.
Y la cosa sobre La crítica es que todos lo pueden hacer.
And everybody does do it.
Y todos en realidad lo hacen.
So if you do it, you're just like everybody else.
Si lo haces, eres como todos los demás.
Then you walk around saying, Hare Krishna, I'm a devotee. Well, then don't act like everybody else if you're a devotee. Stop criticizing.
Y caminas y dices, yo soy devoto. Bueno, entonces deja de actuar como todos los demás. Deja de criticar.
Right?
¿Cierto? There is another one from Shrivas. But
okay.
I understand it could be different kinds of appreciation. I like the techniques that Marshall Rosenberg offer in the book of non-violent communication.
Yeah.
Pero entiendo que hay diferentes tipos de apreciación. Me gusta la técnica de Marshall Rosenberg que ofrece en el libro de comunicación no violenta.
Yeah, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, speak sweetly. Speak
sí,
the
Bhagavad
truth,
Gita.
Speak it. Speak the truth, but speak it sweetly.
Krishna dice, habla la verdad, pero háblala dulcemente.
Nice, right?
Eso es lindo, ¿no?
Not that we don't speak the truth, because you know, maybe someone can't digest it, but we speak it sweetly. There's sugar coating on, so they'll take it.
No, que no hablemos de la verdad, porque eso puede lastimar a alguien, sino que la hablamos de forma dulce, la cubrimos en azúcar.
In the marriage course my wife teaches, I studied it also, and they explain that when you criticize, the person being criticized goes like this. They start defending themselves. It's not a good form of communication.
En el curso de matrimonio que tomó mi esposa, que yo también lo tomé, cuando tú mandas críticas, entonces la persona hace esto y eso no es una buena forma de comunicarse.
So Rasika says, Prem, Prem, after you eat, you should wash your plate. You always leave it on the table. And Prem says, you do it also. It's natural. You just, if you're attacked, you defend yourself. That's the natural human response.
Por ejemplo, Rasika le dice a Prem, después de comer, lava tus platos porque siempre los dejas en la mesa. Y él responde, ah, pero tú haces lo mismo. Y ese es un contraataque, pero es normal, es parte de lo que hacemos como respuesta. Nos atacan y atacamos de vuelta.
And in this training, they explain something I had never heard before that is completely amazing.
En este entrenamiento explican algo que nunca había escuchado antes, que es completamente increíble.
And maybe all the women already understand this, but as a man, I didn't understand this.
Y tal vez todas las mujeres ya entienden esto, pero como hombre yo no lo entendía.
They said like the first few moments of a conversation determine which way it's going. So if you start negative, it just keeps going negative. If you start positive, it keeps going positive. Like
dicen,
like 95% of the time.
Dicen que los primeros minutos de una conversación determinan hacia dónde va a ir. Si empieza siendo negativa, entonces siempre va a ser negativo. Si empieza positiva, siempre va a ser positiva el 95% de las veces.
Rasika says, Prema, it only takes 12 and a half seconds to wash a plate. I timed it, and I'm sure you could find 12, and I know you're busy, but I'm sure you can find 12 and a half seconds to wash that plate. It's already started negative. So he's like, immediately he's like, give me a break, get off my case. And so the conversation just goes down from there.
Entonces Rasika le dice a Prem, solo toma 12 segundos y medio lavar tu plato, no tienes 12 segundos y medio para lavar tu plato, entonces ya empieza la conversación siendo negativa y entonces va a continuar siendo así, negativa.
I think it only takes about 8.5 seconds, actually.
Creo que en realidad solo toma 8 segundos.
maximum 8.5 seconds. Yeah.
Máximo 8.5.
I don't have time, I'm busy.
No tengo tiempo, estoy ocupado.
Isn't that interesting?
¿No es esto interesante?
You start negative and it always any discussion that starts negative, it just gets worse. It doesn't resolve anything.
Una discusión que empieza negativa, entonces continúa siendo negativa y no resuelve nada.
So that's violent communication.
Esa es comunicación violenta.
Yeah. So, you know, it's like this, sometimes we think, well, I didn't say anything wrong. Well, look at the result you got. You know, what do you mean you didn't say anything? No, I just said, what was that? He didn't wash his plate. Yeah, but look at the result. Okay, it's true he didn't wash his plate. But a result of this, you know, takes him 8.5 seconds to wash his plate, and it took you, you know, 45 minutes to convince him to do it. A 45-minute argument. So, you know, you have to look at the result of your conversation.
A veces decimos, pero yo qué dije, qué hice, ¿no? Pero tienes que ver el resultado de las cosas. Puede ser que sí tomé 8 minutos y medio lavar su plato, pero te tardó 45 minutos convencerlo de hacer esto.
You know, another thing about criticism is when you criticize, we could ask you a question. Who authorized you to criticize?
Cuando critiques, hazte la pregunta, ¿quién te autorizó para hacer esto?
I don't think anybody authorized you. Like we didn't ask for your opinion.
Creo que nadie te autorizó, nadie pidió tu opinión. Nadie pidió tu opinión.
Of course, sometimes we, you know, there's problems we have to deal with. I'm just talking about ordinary relationships.
Por supuesto, a veces hay problemas con los que tenemos que lidiar, pero estoy hablando de relaciones ordinarias.
So, now I have a little mantra for you.
Tengo un pequeño mantra para ustedes.
Because the question always comes up, well, if someone's criticizing, what should I do? Because I don't want to
hear. Porque la pregunta siempre surge, ¿no? Si alguien critica, ¿qué debo de hacer?
Here's your mantra.
Aquí está su mantra.
As soon as they start talking to you about some problem with another devotee that you don't want to hear.
Tan pronto como te empiecen a contar de un problema que tienen con otro devoto, el cual no quieres escuchar. Okay.
Prabhu, Prabhu, hold on. I have to go to the toilet.
Prabhu, Prabhu, espéreme, tengo que ir al baño.
And when you come out of the toilet, say, I'm really sorry, I have to go now. And every time they do that, you say, I have to go to the toilet, they'll probably understand after a while that you don't want to hear criticism.
Y cuando regreses del baño, les digas, lo siento, ya me tengo que ir. Y entonces, entre más lo hagas, van a darse cuenta que en realidad no quieres escuchar eso.
Or you could choose your own mantra. Prabhu, my wife's calling. She wants me home now to wash the dishes. I have to go.
O pueden escoger su propio mantra. Oh, mi esposa quiere que vaya a casa para lavar mis platos, que no lave.
You know, my experience is that we take criticism like very lightly, but the Bhagavatam takes it very heavily.
Mi experiencia es que nosotros tomamos la crítica de forma muy ligera, pero el Bhagavatam lo toma de una forma muy muy severa.
And the more advanced the devotee you criticize, the more severe the reaction.
Y entre más avanzado es el devoto que critica, más severa es la reacción.
You remember the story with Daksha, and he offended Lord Shiva, and then his head was cut off.
¿Recuerdan la historia de Daksha que ofendió al señor Shiva y le cortaron la cabeza?
That was a pretty severe reaction.
Esa fue una reacción muy severa.
Ramchandra Puri, he offended Nityananda. The whole village was robbed and burnt as a reaction, and his life was destroyed.
Y como Ramchandra Puri, que ofendió al señor Nityananda, y todo el pueblo fue saqueado y quemado.
Sobhai Muni offended Garuda, and then he ended up like, he was just a single man yogi. He ended up marrying like 50 wives, with like 10 kids each wife.
Como Sabaimuni que ofendió, who did he offend? I'm sorry.
Garuda.
No, Garuda. Que ofendió Sabai Muni, que ofendió a Garuda, y era un hombre soltero que terminó casándose con 50 esposas y tuvo 10 hijos con cada una de ellas.
And you just go down the list. There's so many stories of these horrendous consequences of offending advanced devotees.
Y así podemos tener una lista de cosas horribles que pasan cuando uno ofende a un devoto puro.
So, ladies and gentlemen, don't take it lightly.
Así que, damas y caballeros, no lo tomen a la ligera.
But you know what I think the worst thing is? Aside from the fact that it hurts us, it just pollutes the community. It just creates such a bad atmosphere.
Pero lo peor, aparte de que nos contamina a nosotros, es que contamina a la comunidad. Crea una atmósfera terrible.
Everyone wants to be loved or give love. Nobody wants to be criticized.
Todos quieren dar amor o recibir amor. Nadie quiere ser criticado.
We're going to give a course called Where's the Love? It's in London next
month. Vamos a dar un curso que se llama ¿Dónde está el amor? En Londres.
Yeah. That's what everybody wants.
Eso es lo que todos quieren.
¿Correcto?
Correcto.
Now, Bhaktisiddhanta said, if you have a tendency to criticize, just keep it to yourself and improve yourself.
Bhaktisiddhanta dijo, si tienes una tendencia a criticar, quédatela para ti, trata de mejorarla.
And you know what's interesting about this? This is really a barometer of advancement.
Y lo interesante de esto, es que es un barómetro para el avance.
I've been around some devotees that I have never heard them ever criticize anybody, even when we were talking about a problem, even when, like, I would say something which was like the perfect lead-in for them to respond with a criticism. And they never did, ever.
Yo he estado con devotos que nunca han criticado a nadie, incluso cuando ha habido problemas con esas personas y cuando yo he hablado con ellos y cuando se ha dado una conversación en la que podría dirigirse hacia eso, ellos nunca lo han hecho.
That's called advanced devotee in
eso
my
se
world.
Le llama un devoto avanzado.
Yeah. So, you know, it's really important to understand that what an advanced devotee is, so you can do what they do and not do what they don't do.
Por eso es muy importante entender lo que hace un devoto avanzado para hacerlo y lo que no hace para no hacer eso.
Does that make sense?
¿Tiene sentido? Yes.
Okay, so Kishori Mani wants to know how to fix a problem in a community without criticizing.
Kishori está preguntando cómo resolver un problema en una comunidad sin caer en la crítica.
Well, observing a problem, even if it's created by a person, is different from criticism.
Que abordar un problema de una persona que está pasando en la comunidad es diferente a la crítica.
This person did this, we have to resolve it. That's the conversation
doesn't
go beyond resolving it.
Y la conversación no debe de salirse de tratar de resolver el problema.
If it goes to the point where he's always does that, he's always this, always that, always this, always that, then it's not necessary.
Si llega al punto la conversación en que dice, no, él siempre hace esto otro, hace esto, entonces eso ya no es necesario.
So we go back to the topic of compassion, and if there's compassion there, then that will be the barometer for, you know, as long as we have compassion and Vaishnava etiquette, then I think we'll be okay.
Y regresamos al tema de la compasión, que si hay compasión, entonces todo va a estar bien.
You take away Vaishnava etiquette and compassion, then you could create a problem.
Si hay etiqueta Vaishnava y compasión, todo va a estar bien. Si uno quita la etiqueta Vaishnava y la compasión, entonces van a haber problemas.
And then you want to keep in mind, if there's a problem, what's the goal? Is the goal to hang that person, or is the goal to solve the problem?
Y tienes que mantener en mente cuál es el objetivo. El objetivo es resolver el problema o colgar a la persona.
Or is the goal to deface that person because you don't like them?
O el problema es quitarle el rostro a esa persona porque no te agrada, ¿no?
You know, we have to remember that it's no small thing to be a devotee, and we can't just act based on how we feel. There has to be etiquette, there has to be culture, there has to be sattvic qualities through which we act. That's really important.
Y tenemos que recordar que no es algo pequeño ser un devoto. Tenemos que tener cultura, tenemos que tener etiqueta sattvica, tenemos que tener todas estas cosas.
Because, you know, it's easy to solve a problem in a tamasic way, isn't it?
Porque es fácil resolver un problema de forma tamásica, ¿no es así?
Just beat them up and throw them out on the street. Problem's over.
Solo golpéalos y tíralos a la calle. Y se resuelve el problema, ¿no es así?
And tell him if he comes back, we'll call the police. Yeah, problem's finished.
Y si regresan, llamamos a la policía y así se acabó el problema.
Generally, we don't do that. We should
Pero
not do that.
En general no hacemos eso. No debemos de hacer eso.
Some rare exception, yeah. But we had to do that once with a devotee.
En alguna rara excepción, sí. De hecho, una vez tuvimos que hacer eso con un devoto.
He was creating so many problems in the temple. We asked him to leave. He wouldn't leave.
Él creó tantos problemas en el templo y le pedimos que se fuera y no se fue.
We actually had to pick him up and put him on the street.
Tuvimos que de hecho recoger en nuestros brazos, ponerlo y sacarlo del templo.
Yeah. So there may be a rare case, but generally we wouldn't do that.
Puede haber un caso raro, pero en general no hacemos eso.
This was in 1970. We were a little passionate.
Esto fue en los 70s. Nosotros éramos un poco pasionales.
It was crazy.
Era muy loco.
Yeah. Prabhupada's taking a bunch of young Americans and spreading Krishna consciousness. That was like insane.
Prabhupada tomó muchos estadounidenses jóvenes y los puso a predicar. Eso fue una locura.
It doesn't make any sense.
No tiene ningún sentido.
It shouldn't have happened.
No debió de haber pasado.
That's testimony to the power of Krishna consciousness.
Ese es el testimonio del poder de la conciencia de Krishna.
This is Prabhupada sending people all over the world. And, you know, like a year before that, they were just, you know, full-on hippies. Like, it shouldn't work.
Prabhupada mandando a muchos jóvenes alrededor del mundo cuando un año anterior eran unos hippies. Eso no debió de haber funcionado.
Here's our business plan. We'll get some hippies off the street, shave their head, put some bed sheets on them, get them to jump up and down on the street chanting a mantra, and a year later we'll send them around the world, you know. Do we have any investors? Anybody interested? I don't think we'll get it.
Este es el modelo de nuestro negocio, ¿no? Agarra un montón de jóvenes y que un año anterior habían sido hippies y ponles una sábana encima y rapa la cabeza y sácalos a alrededor del mundo.
No.
Hay alguien que quiere invertir en esto.
I was telling the devotees the other day that when you see Prabhupada, you just want to completely surrender everything. That's how you feel when you see him.
Yo le estaba diciendo a unos devotos que cuando veíamos a Prabhupada, completamente queríamos entregarle todo a él. Así es como nos sentíamos.
Now, don't you think that would be useful as a preaching tool if everyone who saw you wanted to completely give their life to Krishna just by seeing you?
¿No sería eso muy útil que todas las personas que te vieran quisieran entregarle su vida a Krishna solo al verte?
Well, that's why we were successful against all odds, because Prabhupada endowed us with that desire to just give everything to Krishna, and that's what we did.
Por eso fuimos exitosos, porque Prabhupada nos dotó con ello.
But without that inspiration of a pure devotee, I don't think it could have happened.
Pero sin la inspiración de un devoto puro, eso no hubiera pasado.
I mean, you have no idea what it's like to see Prabhupada, what it makes you feel like.
No tienen idea lo que era ver a Prabhupada, lo que te hacía sentir.
You know, a lot of devotees ask, they say, well, you Prabhupada disciples, you did all this austerity, you did all these things we would never do, we've never done, we'll never do in the future, you were so surrendered, etc., etc. And I say, yeah, well, if you saw Prabhupada, you'd do it also. That's the difference. You saw him, you'd feel like doing that as well.
Porque los devotos ahora nos dicen, no, ustedes discípulos de Prabhupada, ustedes lo entregaron todo, hicieron tanta austeridad, nosotros nunca podríamos haber hecho eso y nunca podremos hacer eso. Pero si ustedes hubieran visto a Prabhupada, también lo hubieran hecho.
You want to hear something funny?
¿Quieren escuchar algo gracioso?
So I went to South Africa in 1981. That was after 11 years I'd been a devotee.
Yo fui a África en 1981, eso fue 11 años de que yo había sido devoto.
So we sleep on the floor in a sleeping bag. That's the plan. That's what we did.
En el piso, en una bolsa de dormir, eso era lo que hacíamos.
And I went to South Africa in 1981, and they had these little mats about 3/4 inch thick that they slept on.
Y yo fui a Sudáfrica en 1981 y tenían estos colchones que eran como de 3/4 de pulgada.
And I thought, oh my God, these devotees are in complete maya. They're sleeping on a mat. That's what I thought.
Y yo pensé, oh, estos devotos están en completa maya porque están durmiendo en estos colchones.
We just, you know, gave up everything for Prabhupada and just did what we had to do. That was
Porque
the power of seeing him, yeah.
Solo entregamos todo a Prabhupada, hicimos lo que teníamos que hacer. Ese era el poder de haberlo visto.
I don't know how I got off on that tangent.
No sé cómo me fui por esa tangente.
Can anybody tell me how we got onto that road?
¿Alguien me puede decir cómo llegamos a eso?
I don't know. But it's a good road. It's a good road.
No sé, pero es un buen camino por el cual ir.
If, you know, if you ever wondered how all of us young people did it, there's your answer. We just saw Prabhupada and we wanted... That darshan made us want to give everything to Krishna, and that's what we did.
Si alguna vez se preguntan cómo nosotros de jóvenes lo hicimos, fue debido a Prabhupada. Al ver a Prabhupada, queríamos entregarle todo a Krishna, y eso es lo que hicimos.
Have you heard any stories that seem crazy? Like, you know, bathing in the snow, bathing with ice in the snow and things of that nature? Now you know why. Because once you see Prabhupada, you just want to surrender completely.
¿Se han escuchado historias de devotos bañándose en agua helada, en la nieve? Entonces, ahora saben por qué lo hicimos.
Lakshya was saying that I was saying, do what an advanced devotee does.
Oh, yeah, you were saying that, exactly. Que Alakri estaba diciendo que debemos de seguir lo que hace un devoto avanzado.
You want to hear something? It's a side point. This is really beautiful. I put
escuchar?
It on, I think it's on Facebook today.
¿Quieren escuchar un punto aparte? Es increíble. Creo que lo puse en Facebook.
Prabhupada said, don't just eulogize, which means glorify. Don't just glorify your spiritual master. But do what he does.
que decía, no solo glorifiques a tu maestro espiritual, sino haz lo que él hizo.
Jai Prabhupada, you're the savior of the world, all glories to you, you know. And Prabhupada's like, do something. You save the world also, you know. Don't just glorify me, do what I'm doing.
Jai Prabhupada, todas las glorias a ti, tú salvaste el mundo. No solo me, y él diciendo, no solo me glorifiques, haz algo también tú también puedes salvar al mundo.
Beautiful, huh? Isn't it?
Hermoso, ¿no es así?
Coming from, you know, I could say that, but coming from Prabhupada's lotus mouth, that's powerful.
Yo puedo decir esto, pero viniendo de la boca del loto de Prabhupada, eso es realmente poderoso.
Srivas has been, he's done the ice shower, is that correct? You've been there, done that?
Que Shrivas, se ha bañado en agua helada, ya ha hecho eso, ha estado ahí.
Yeah.
In Gurukul. So if you... In Gurukul, they...
Oh,
in
Gurukul. Oh, okay. Yeah.
En el Gurukula.
It was so funny.
Fue muy gracioso.
Tapasya. Necessary, yeah.
Tapasya necesaria.
Yeah, if you go on my Facebook, you can find that quote. Or maybe it shows up on your Facebook. It's a beautiful quote.
Si van a mi Facebook, pueden encontrar esta cita.
So, can I go now?
¿Ya me puedo ir?
Yes, of course. Thank you so much, Gurudev.
Did I pay my dues? We got over an hour and a half.
Ya pagué mi cuenta. Ya fue más de una hora y media. Yes, thank you so much.
Okay. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Muchas gracias.
Hare Krishna.
Nitananda.
Jai.
Thank you. Que estén muy bien. Nos vemos.
Hare Krishna.